a way to bring a little spirit to our campus. I see some clapping out there. Clearly it was a little windy yesterday when our spirit team recorded that for us, though. You can hear a little bit of that northern wind coming through. But what I love about it, and I see that in the video today, and I saw it when I was walking around campus a bit today too, our students are taking the pandemic seriously. You see them with their masks on. You see them trying to keep each other safe and contain the spread of this virus. And I've been incredibly impressed by their responsibility and how they've addressed it. My name is Christy Bollander, and I'm the Associate Vice President for Advancement and your Executive Director of the Alumni Association. And I guess I get to be the first one to officially welcome you to Homecoming, Stay Homecoming 2020. As President McConnell was saying as we were logging on, this is like nothing else we have ever seen for Homecoming, is it? I never in my career thought that we'd be hosting a virtual barbecue. But when we broke down in the Alumni Association, what does Homecoming mean to us? What is special about it? It's about gathering with you all. It's about community. It's about celebrating our Ram pride. So in that spirit, we wanted to at least spend 30 minutes tonight gathering you all and celebrating all that is special about Colorado State University. For those of you who maybe are thinking that I'm going to be ringing your doorbell here in a little bit, delivering some barbecue, that's not the way this program is going to go. So hopefully you were like Bob Johnson and you had an amazing homecoming barbecue already, or you're planning to later. And I'd love to point out our cookbook that you should have gotten with your registration link. A whole bunch of our alumni sent in their favorite recipes. And so it's a great way for you to and maybe sample some of somebody else's favorites. A few quick tips to make this evening successful. If you could just keep yourself on mute, that would be awesome. If you could turn on your camera so we can see each other, that would be amazing if you're interested. And if you could just participate in the chat, I see it going crazy right now where everybody's putting in their name and year, which I think is fantastic. What do we all have in common that are on this call tonight besides your love of CSU? You are all members of the Alumni Association, and I hope you know truly how much your special support of the Alumni Association means to us. We see this as your vote of confidence back in your alma mater, and we really, really appreciate your special support. We have 14,000 members, over 14,000 members now in the Alumni Association across the country, and tonight, we have 26 states that are represented in our program, all the way from Alaska to Maine to Florida. So thank you all for joining in tonight. That's one of the special things, I guess, about having virtual homecoming is that we can all gather together in this way. We have an action-packed quick 30 minutes with a lot of special guests. And I would really love to introduce you to our very first special guest, the 15th president of Colorado State University, President Joyce McConnell.
Hello, everyone. I'm just thrilled to be here with all of you. For those of you who I met last year, welcome back. For those of you who I haven't met yet, I can't wait to meet you. Make sure to come. This will be over someday and we'll all be together again. And that is worth celebrating. But I wish we were all here celebrating with a bonfire this evening. Although I have to tell you, for those of you who aren't in Fort Collins, we've been having wildfires close by. And the air is really heavy with smoke tonight. So I don't know whether we would have had the bonfire or not, but just remember it in your memory, how beautiful it is at night. I'm so glad we can do this together virtually to be together and show our CSU Ram spirit, especially at a time when focusing on the positive is so important. And for us to be able to be together, even if it's just virtual, really has significance to me. And so I want to thank all of you for giving me this great homecoming gift, because if you all weren't here, I would be sitting at home eating my homecoming meal and feeling alone. So I'm so, so happy that you're here. One of the things that I think we're grieving the loss of, and I've talked to a lot of our students and faculty staff about this, we're grieving the loss of celebration. You know, we can't be together in the way that we love being together, celebrating the things that are important to us. But every day, the spirit of the university fills me with hope, and your spirit fills me with hope. I want to thank you all for being here tonight. It's really incredible to see your photographs or your images on the screen. And as soon as I'm done, I'm going to flick through and just see your beautiful faces. Our Alumni Association has a wonderful schedule of events lined up for you. And I deeply appreciate everything they've done. Christy, thank you so much. And thank you to your team for pulling this all together. I know it isn't easy, but it's important. So thank you so much. And now I actually get to introduce one of my best friends and someone I love hanging out with. I get to introduce Spirit Cam. So have a wonderful evening, everyone. I'm going to scroll through, look at your pictures. I'll chat with you. So awesome to see you all. Thank you so much. Go Rams.
Thank you so much, President McConnell. I have missed you. I appreciate
I've missed you too, Christy.
Yes, I appreciate you very much. Now, I don't see Spirit Cam just yet. Is our cam rolling around on this screen somewhere? It's kind of hard for Cam to join us because he does not speak. He's our nonverbal mascot. So for him to be on Zoom is always super fun. But he joins our spirit in being a great representative.
I can't tell if I'm in or not.
You're right there, Mitch.
I know, but that's not me.
Yeah, that is.
And it quit.
Hi, Mitch.
Oh, hi there.
How are you?
Sorry, hi. It took forever to try to get my computer to work on Zoom, so here we are.
Glad you are just in time for me to alert everybody about where to find all of the homecoming activities. Homecoming.colostate.edu is our website, and alumni.colostate.edu also has a whole bunch of other programming, not just this weekend, but you all are always invited to participate in. I echo President McConnell's comments. Our staff has been doing amazing work at bringing together great content, and I see a lot of you out there on the screen tonight, so just know how much you are appreciated and bringing such great connections to our alumni. Ram Athletics is typically an anchor for us during homecoming weekend. Since we are not in competition right now, we thought it would be really fun to bring the most winning coach in CSU history to us tonight. At the end of 2019, Tom Hilbert ranked 9th among active Division I head coaches for winning percentage and 7th in the nation for total wins. He is a 12-time Mountain West Coach of the Year and has guided our CSU Rams to the NCAA tournament 23 consecutive years, every year since he has been a Colorado State University Ram. Coach Hilbert, can you unmute yourself and say hello? We're so glad to have you with us tonight.
Hello, Christy, and hello, everybody out there. This is, in a normal year, and even this year, this is my favorite weekend of the year because it's a big family reunion. That's how I always see it. It's a big family reunion. We're all a big Ram family, and this is our reunion, and you get to see people you haven't seen in a long time, and, you know, we're just doing it over the computer now. It's the same thing.
It's not quite the same thing, but I'm glad you love it, Tom, and I'm glad we're able to do this. I have to say one of my personal claim to fame, Tom, and you may not remember this, but back in 1997, I was on your search committee
when I do remember that.
when we brought you to Fort Collins. And I'd love for you, I have a couple of questions I'd love to throw your way, that if you don't mind. And the first one, going back to 1997, tell us about your experience of living in Fort Collins and being a member of the Northern Colorado community.
Well, it's the reason I've stayed here so long. You know, I've been here 23 years, and it's because I love living here. It's because this community embraces my sport. They embrace all sports, but they really embrace my sport, and which makes it special. You know, we bring in opponents from the best conferences in the country, and they come into Moby Arena. They see the environment we have there. They see how the community of Fort Collins really supports us, and they say to me, "You have got an unbelievable thing going here. This is a great job," and it really is. And I've always loved living in Fort Collins because I think it's not only do they love volleyball and embrace sports, but it's a perfect size community. It's still kind of got a small town feel, but it's big enough to have a lot of, you know, art and culture. So I just absolutely love it. You know, I can tell you right now, I think people probably look at me right now and think he's got some kind of fancy background. This is actually the terrace on my new condo. And I'm going to stand up and show you here. We're overlooking Ginger and Baker, you know, and I've got the whole old town Fort Collins in my background here. I love living down here. And, you know, I'm one of these people that I can't wait for this COVID stuff to be over so I can get back, go up to New Belgium or go down to Old Town, you know, and hang out you know, just be part of this community, because I think it's such a great place to live.
Well, thank you. This brings the home into a homecoming, that you're calling from home, President McConnell, you're calling in from home, and clearly I'm at home too. Mm-hmm. Tom, you have the responsibility of a lot of our student athletes and their experience. Can you share a little bit right now about the student athlete experience during this time of COVID?
Sure, I will. And it's been difficult because you look at them from different reasons. You know, we don't have a season this fall. We think we're going to have a season starting at the beginning of February. But the seniors who, you know, are normally planning for their future and their life after college are now trying to debate whether or not they're going to have another season. The freshmen come in, and they had a certain expectation of what college was supposed to be like, and it's not like that. So we, as a coaching staff, you know, we have focused our efforts on developing trust, developing bonds between small groups of players, you know, the classes, for example. We have seven freshmen this year, and we want those kids to get to know each other really well, hang out with each other really well. But we still have to follow all the safety protocols. We mask up in practice. We don't go to big gatherings. We don't meet unless we're distanced or on virtual, but we're still trying to do the same things. We're still trying to create a meaningful experience for these student athletes. And I think, you know, so far it's worked pretty well. We had an inter-squad scrimmage the other night in Moby Arena. It was an empty arena, but we put it on Zoom and we had 100 and some people watch it. And a lot of the parents watch it, and the players got excited for it because they're wearing uniforms and everything. So we're trying to give them this experience.
Well, I admire that. I know this is an unprecedented time. And Tom, I know you don't know I'm going to ask you this, but there was one of your student athlete experiences that was just recently highlighted in the media, a freshman, I do believe, who came to campus and was quickly quarantined. Do you mind sharing a little bit about her experience and how the university was able to support her?
Yeah, she came in. Freshman from Colorado Springs, 17 years old, wasn't even 18 yet. And the first day she was on campus, one of her other fellow freshmen tested positive for COVID, asymptomatic, but all of the freshmen that were hanging out with that player had to quarantine for 14 days in their dorm room alone. She got out of that quarantine, and within another day, she had been exposed to another athlete, and she was quarantined for another 10 days, got out of that for 2 days, and then was quarantined for another 14 days. So, I mean, this is not something that a 17-year-old should have to do. And, you know, we were very concerned about her mental health, about her well-being. We made sure that people were staying in contact with her. People were talking to her through the window of her dorm room. I mean, it was an amazing, not amazing, it was a difficult thing for her to go through, but it was an amazing response from all of her teammates and from us as coaches. And we're trying to do, you know, she one time I called her and she goes, you know, I really want mashed potatoes and gravy. I really want mashed potatoes and gravy. So I searched all over this entire town to find her, you know, some good mashed potatoes and gravy and took it to her dorm, you know. I mean, those are the kind of things that we're trying to do to make sure people feel like they're being taken care of. And that was a very difficult time for her. And she's now thriving as a player and doing a great job with us. But she had to spend 35 days in quarantine.
Well, thank you for sharing that. And I know you're going to be mad at me for saying this, but that shows why you're such a winning coach, Tom. The care that you put into your student athletes to make sure that they're taken care of at CSU is impressive. Yeah.
And Christy, it's a team effort. I mean, I've got great assistant coaches who work very hard at this too. We all work at it. We all believe, you know, we're really on the front lines with the athletes, and we still have to keep this trust going. We still have to keep them motivated. And that's hard to do in this COVID environment. And we've got a lot of people telling us you can do this, you can't do this, you got to stand 6 feet apart, whatever. But we have to really work with these kids every day and keep their trust and their motivation going. And that's been our biggest challenge.
Well, you do a fantastic job. Moby Mattis, since this is homecoming, let's imagine we're back in Moby right now. Yeah. For some Moby Madness, which is crazy electric during your home matches. What does playing at home mean to you, Coach Hilbert, and to your teams over the years?
I would say that it is besides the athletic talent of our players, Moby Madness is the thing that is responsible for our success. You know, we've recruited great athletes and we get them in here and we train them, but they find such energy in our home match environment. And there is nothing else in the Mountain West like our place. And it, you know, the opponents dread coming to Moby Arena, and our players love playing there every night. And I mean, and I heard one of them say one time, you know, you come out to practice and you're grinding through practice and every day, and you're wondering, and then you start thinking about, why do we do this? Well, it's because of all these people that come to watch us, you know, these people that love our program. It really means something to those players. And so I think it's a catalyst for how hard they work. It's a catalyst for the energy they play with every day. It's a catalyst for our success.
You bring us so much pride, Coach Hilbert, and I really appreciate you joining us here. I'm going to ask one favor before we let you off the hook for the rest of the night. Can you look over to the mountain where the A is and tell me if you can see it, or is the smoke prohibiting your view?
Yeah, it's too smoky. Too smoky, because I normally can see the A from this view, and I can't see it.
Okay. Well, Coach Hilbert, thank you again for joining us. We cannot wait until we can cheer you and our Ram volleyball team on to victory again in Moby. But thank you.
Can I say, Christy, that just looking over there, I can picture that A. And I can see it and up on Hogback Mountain, and I can picture it, and I love seeing it every time I take a look in that direction. So go Rams, everybody. Let's love CSU, and let's love the Aggies.
Yay, go Rams. Well, I brought up if he could see the A tonight because some of you may have heard that we are moving forward with our traditional lighting of the A as part of homecoming. Concerned a little bit about the smoke, and for all of you who are calling in from out of state, at 8 o'clock tonight, if you go to the Alumni Association Facebook site, you'll be able to see it live. So even if you can't see it, Coach Hilbert, from your fancy rooftop, or if you're like me, all the way out on the other side of the interstate, and the smoke has definitely prohibited our view, we can log in together at 8 o'clock on Facebook and get a glimpse of the lighting of the A. A few facts about this tonight. It's lit already. I'm getting some pictures and texts from some of our alumni who are living on the western side of Fort Collins that say that they can see it. Rhythm EFX has helped us tonight in lighting it and keeping this tradition going. Again, 8 o'clock tonight, we can log in. And a quick fun fact about the A, it is a 450 by 210 foot symbol of our Ram Pride. You maybe heard, or maybe along the way are wondering about how we're going to get painted this fall. You just stay tuned and keep your eye on the A, especially this month of October. Typically, this is done through students and a lot of volunteers who go up in an effort to keep those students safe and keep them not gathering, but still move the A painting forward. We've enlisted some help of a couple of local alumni. So you get the inside scoop on the A will be refreshed this fall to make us all so proud. As before we introduce our next guest, I thought it would be really fun, in the spirit of what Bob Johnson brought, to look back 50 years on our campus to 1970. It was a crazy time at Colorado State University. Old Main burned in 1970, something that so many of our alumni still feel like it was yesterday when they watched that iconic building burn. Two football greats had unprecedented football seasons. Lawrence McCutcheon rushed for our first 1,000-yard season at Colorado State, and Early Thomas, who many of you probably remember went on to Denver Bronco greatness, was just starting off his career at CSU. In case you didn't know about Early Thomas, I have a fun little story. He went on to get his PhD in entomology from Colorado State University. And his very first year of playing football for the Broncos was invited to participate in the Pro Bowl. He passed on the Pro Bowl so he could come and defend his dissertation, so he could complete his PhD. And he served his alma mater for many, many years as a faculty member on campus. We had our first Black homecoming queen in 1970. So a lot of the issues of 2020, you look back on 1970 and can really see the pathway to where we are today. Our next guest, Dakota, I'm hoping that our timing is pretty good right here. Our next guest is a musical talent, 2001 Business Administration alumnus. Jon Wolfe was just recently featured in Around the Oval, which is the member magazine that you all receive. Jon is a country music artist, has 50 million streams on Spotify alone already, and 10 consecutive number one singles on the Texas Regional Radio Report, including his most recent single, Feels Like Country Music. His new single, titled Heart to Steal Tonight, I do believe is what we're going to get to hear him play live here in a few minutes. Jon has also launched his own tequila line, Juan Lobo Tequila, which ships nationwide. For those of you who would like to stay and listen to Jon Wolfe perform for us, we would love for you to stay on here. You can also hop on our Instagram account where he's going to be performing live as well. For the rest of you, please just know how much we value your Ram Pride and you sharing part of your evening tonight. Please wear your green tomorrow as you're out and about in whatever community you may be in, and make sure you're talking about the amazing tradition of Colorado State University. Don't forget the lighting of the A as well. If you're in Western Fort Collins, you may be able to see it live. Otherwise, at 8 o'clock, please log on to the Facebook site so you can check it out. And thank you again for all that you do for Colorado State University. Go Rams!
It's on right now, sorry about that.
Dakota, I don't think we can hear it just yet.
I just rocked the Juan Lobo instead. But we were actually just in Fort Collins. I think it's been, I'm referencing my wife over here briefly. Was it like a month ago?
Think so.
Yeah, and we stocked up on a few things, dude, but I didn't get a new hat, so I'm just gonna rock it all over.
We'll make sure you get a new hat, I promise. You know, I manage Cayman, the ram handlers, and I got a text from one of the ram handlers, and he said, hey, Jon Wolfe's an alum, right? I just saw him at Odell.
Nice.
So you're famous around these parts, my friend.
Dude, I'm an Odell maniac. You know, I remember this dates me a little bit, of course, but I when I was in school, 90 shilling was just kind of like, you know, the beer that you would get down at Tony's, or of course, I've got my wife just also brought me a 90 right here. So, but, you know,
look 90s, at that love.
Yeah. 90 is just kind of the beer you get at Tony's or Lucky Joe's, you know, and as the craft beer industry exploded, I kept looking everywhere in Texas to get it, and it's finally here now. So, but I'm a big Odell fan.
So. I remember saying that when I moved to Denver, I was like, "Hey, back where I went to college in Fort Collins, 90 shilling fat tire was the same price as Bud Light, so we drank the good stuff."
That's right. That's right, man.
Yeah. Well, for those of you who don't know, Jon Wolfe and I did an article for the member magazine. So thanks to all our members. And we've got some people tuning in to this Instagram Live via the Homecoming Barbecue. So welcome, awesome. Everybody on that feed.
Love it. Yeah. Love it. Happy Homecoming, everybody. Go Rammies. Yeah. Happy Homecoming.
Go Rammies. A lot has happened since we last talked, my friend. I was just reading the article today, and there we mentioned that the single Feels Like Country Music was just about to hit radio. That went number one already.
It has.
So congratulations.
Thank you. It's been a challenging year, like it has for everybody, but we're really thankful to still be able to, you know, keep things rolling this year and put out music, and we're excited to be approaching the fourth quarter in football season, and things are feeling a little bit better out there.
Yeah. Rammies are coming back October 24th, if you haven't heard.
Love it. Love it. I'm excited.
Well, we talked about a lot, but will you share, I don't know if we actually talked about this, but one of your favorite CSU memories.
Well, you know, I think for me, Colorado State was, the way I ended up in Fort Collins was really, I grew up in Oklahoma, so I fell in love with the outdoors, first of all. And, at the time, my girlfriend at the time, who's also a CSU alum, I can thank her for taking me to Fort Collins and showing me Fort Collins. So I really just fell in love with, first and foremost, fell in love with Colorado and I love the outdoors. And then I just love the vibe in Fort Collins. You know, it was, you know, to me, and again, you know, I'm dating myself for everybody out there. I graduated in 01, man. So that's like, it's been a while. But, you know, to me, I just loved the town at the time. You know, I love it now. I really feel like the Fort Collins done especially the Old Town area and the university, I think has done an amazing job. I told my wife the entire time, I was really floored with how that part of town has developed, because some towns or cities may not grow in the right way, you know. So, but at the time for me, I just loved the small town feel of Fort Collins. I loved how.
Okay, it sounds like Instagram is having a quick volume issue. So, Kathy, it's not
John,
just you.
Just got word. Hey, your audio cut out, John. Can you hear me? Hey, can you hear me? If you'll give me some comments.
I can hear you.
Was it just John that cut out, or can you hear me as well?
I can.
Just John cut out. His video's out.
Perfect. We'll ask John to come back in then here. All right. He's coming back in.
Okay.
All righty, we're back.
All right, so where did I cut out at? Where did I cut out?
Where did we cut out? We're talking about some of the opportunities of CSU.
Was I about to go into my favorite memory? I set it up a little bit.
I think that's a perfect point. Yeah, you got here from Oklahoma, and the special one brought you out.
Yeah, again, just a big fan of Fort Collins as a town. Always felt like it's just very personable. And of course I got a million memories from my days at CSU and Fort Collins. I mean, you guys could leave me on here for hours and talk about it, but, you know, I used to go to class. One of the things I told my wife about this is that I used to go to class, with my fly rod and my fly fishing vest in my truck. And as soon as I finished class, I would hit shields and head north, and I'd be on the Poudre River in about 30 minutes fly fishing. So those are always, you know, where else can you do that? I mean, there's not many places you can do that. And so that's a great memory. And then, of course, I love all the guys at Lucky Joe's, but they kicked me out of Lucky Joe's a bunch, but they always let me back in. So that's my second favorite memory is hanging out at Lucky Joe's and drinking beer.
That's perfect. And you grew up near Tulsa, right?
Yeah.
So not a whole lot of fly fishing, if I remember.
No. I definitely learned in Colorado for sure.
Yeah. Well, Colt Hilbert with the volleyball team is from Norman, around Norman. So
excellent.
I feel like a lot of Oklahomans make their way out here.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah.
Well, another thing that happened is that Juan Lobo is now shipping nationwide, which wasn't the case before. So congratulations.
Thank you. And I'm drinking a little bit right now.
Nice.
If anybody wants to go check out Juan Lobo, it's JuanLoboTequila.com, as well as we're Juan Lobo Tequila on Instagram as well. So check us out. And I'm pretty sure it does ship to Colorado. And you guys are next on our list to open the state. So we're trying to get some tequila out there to you guys.
Perfect. Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers.
Well, my friend, I think the last thing we talked about in the article was, you know, we might have some people here who haven't heard Jon Wolfe before, and you told them to check out a song at that time, which was Simul Bar in the 90s, I believe. But what about now? Like, now that you're talking to the people, what should they check out? What should they tune into?
Yeah, so I do have my guitar here. I'll play you guys a song.
Perfect.
If you want me to. And
please.
We have a new single that's out on Texas radio called Heart to Steal Tonight. That's doing great, and it's on the current EP, Feels Like Country Music. Also,
I think we lost you again, John. I think we lost your audio. I can see you. You're moving. All right, he's coming right back, and then we'll get the song.
You got me now.
Technology is fun, isn't it?
You know what I'm seeing it? You know what it is? The new iPhone update. If somebody calls me, it cuts out.
You're popular.
Yeah, I don't know. So, hopefully, maybe if I could go to, Jeffrey says, try to dial up. We got a request for plenty of something I can drink to. I want to check out some. What I could do is throw this on airplane mode real quick. Why don't we do that?
Okay.
Let me just.
Hope you know what you're doing, John.
I'm back, dude.
Perfect.
Okay. So, okay. We got a request for play me something I can drink to, which I can do that. No problem. Okay. Appreciate you guys and your comments. I want to take just a second. I'm looking at some of these. So thank you guys again. So we got a brand new album that I'm working on right now. That's going to come out next late spring of next year. The current EP is Feels Like Country Music. Current single is Hard to Steal Tonight. Some Old Bar in the 90s is also now very popular. And then you and I were talking about Feels Like Country Music.
Yeah. Very special song. We talked about, we reminisced about some of the old country songs and how it just tells such a story, and that song for me, it became one of my favorite Jon Wolfe songs immediately because it captured that feeling for me. So thanks for putting that one out. I think it was a great thing to impact radio, and when Absolutely. I saw this week that Hard to Steal Tonight is impacting country Texas radio, I was excited. That's a great choice.
I appreciate that. So I do have my guitar, man.
Perfect.
I thought I'd bust out a I was already thinking about Play Me Something I Can Drink To.
Cool.
Just because it's one of the old classics for me. And we will be back in Fort Collins. It's going to be first quarter of, I'm pretty sure it'll be first quarter of next year. So we'll be back playing for you guys, likely either Sundance or Aggie Theater. So, cool. So yeah, here's an oldie for you guys. I'll bust one out. It is Friday, and it's probably should be drinking already if you're not. Didn't come in here to dance. I don't plan to have a good time. So honey, just top off this glass. Take this pocket full of dimes. Go wake up that old jukebox. Just leave me alone. Got a past to put behind, so keep one thing in mind when you're picking out them songs. Play me something I can drink to, something I can sit and think to. It's all about nothing left to lose, someone who's been in my shoes. Play it loud enough to drown out all the hell I'm going through. Make it something I can cry to. Tune her memory can die to. Got a table in the dark, bottle and a broken heart. Maybe something I can drink to. I've got everything I need to get me where I'm going.
and I get there, I'll be free. Only for tonight. As long as that steel guitar is playing, she'll be going, going, gone. Well, I got a ghost to kill, and I know this whiskey will. With some help from Hank and Jones. So lay me something I can drink to. Something I can sit and think to. A song about nothing left to lose. Someone who's been in my shoes. Played loud enough to drown out all the hell I'm going through. Make it something table in the dark, a bottle and a broken heart. Maybe something I can drink to. I've got nowhere else to go, so keep on coming sad and slow. Play me something I can drink to. Drinking song for you guys on a Friday night.
Awesome. I got lots of hearts coming through the feed, so I know they appreciate it.
Good. Good. Thanks again, brother.
Of course. Thank you. We you were just talking about before we cut off too, the new single, Heart to Steal Tonight.
Yeah, you know, Heart to Steal Tonight was kind of not initially a wedding song for my wife and I, but it kind of became that, you know. So Heart to Steal Tonight went out to Texas radio just really a couple weeks ago, and it's already doing a great job. So we're excited about that. Folks are, it seems like radio is excited about it, and it typically goes over really well in live shows as well. So we're pumped about that. And the new album has, what you're going to see next year is, there's a lot to this new album, the way the album was created, the storyline behind it. I kind of went back to doing a lot of writing on this new record, which I sort of wrote a lot on my first record, but not as much on the following record. So this is, I guess, because I have a lot of time on my hands this year. so yeah, you know, with the new record's gonna be different and cool. Like it's definitely, you know, so when I say it's gonna be different, sometimes my fans go, uh-oh, this isn't good, or, you know, I think it's gonna be different in a good way. And it's definitely not any less country. It may be even more country than my previous record. So just know that.
Well, we were talking about how there was a trend a little bit where country sounded a little bit more pop, and recently some of those traditions were coming back in, and it sounded a little bit more like country to me too. So, and one thing you wanted to make sure that the fans knew was that you're always going to keep it authentic country music. So I know you're going to do that with this new one.
Absolutely, man. And I think that's pretty much, you know, what I started out doing. I just love traditional country. Some of my stuff has been a little more mainstream than other things through the records, but it's always maintained that tie to traditional country. And, you know, fortunately, you know, I haven't really been constrained by the influence of record labels. I've been able to kind of create my own sound, you know, make my own decisions. And it's a little, sometimes it's a tougher way to go. but you are able to maintain creative control.
Sure.
So I think you guys will really dig the new stuff, and we'll make that announcement in January, February. And there's going to be some cool, I haven't told anybody about this stuff, so you guys are getting early information, but I'm going to be trying to bring you guys into the process of the record.
Cool.
Really show you sort of the record being created, even to the very early parts of the songwriting sessions. So yeah, that's all I can tell you so far, man.
That's plenty. Thanks for sharing with us. We appreciate it. Well, and last time I saw Lisa in the comments, we were getting ready to see in Sundance, I think it was May, and then up in Cowboy and Laramie. So
yeah.
And then, you know, what happened, but we're excited to welcome you back, and maybe we can do a little alumni showing and alumni event for that.
Would love that. And man, I just appreciate you guys having me on.
Of course.
And you know, we wish we were there with you guys in Fort Collins tonight. So again, happy homecoming. Thanks again for having me.
Cheers, everyone. Are you going to play us out with one more?
Yeah, I'll do one more for you guys.
Okay. All righty.
So far for me, Boots on a Dance Floor has kind of been in a lot of ways, it's kind of been a career changing song for me. I think it's well over 11 or 12 million, plays on Spotify. Has really been a big song for me. So I thought I'd bust this out for you guys. A little Boots on a Dance Floor. Coffee strong, hit the road. All racetrack, none of the fast songs on the radio. If the skyline changing, dirt road, paving and dance, you better lock your door. We're a 40-hour grind, not counting overtime, but Friday night on the back porch. Boots on a dance floor, birds on a wire, red on a barn door, ring on fire. Out in the blue sky, rolling along, all free and easy, just like a song. In a world full of running and chasing down money, and me and you were moving at our own pace, honey, like curves on an old Ford. Like boots on a dance floor. At the time the sun's setting, we'll be getting where we want to be. Got a plan, got your hands in the back pockets of my jeans. Got the footland setting low, country go radio coming through the window screen. When we find our feet, we don't miss a beat. That's the thing about you and me. Boots on a dance floor, birds on a wire, red on a barn door, ring on fire. Out in a blue sky, rolling along, all free and easy, just like a song. In a world full of running and chasing down, honey, and me and you are moving at our own pace, honey, like curves on an old Ford, like boots on a dance floor. Boots on a dance floor, birds on a wire, red on a barn door, ring on fire. Cloud in a blue sky, rolling along, all free and easy, just like a song.
in a world full of running and chasing down money. Me and you were moving at our own pace, honey, like curves on an old Ford, like boots on a dance floor. You and me are like boots on a dance floor. Yeah, we're like red on a barn door. You and me are like curves on an old Ford, like boots on a dance floor.
Yeah.
All right. Well, awesome. Good fun to dance for with you guys there.
Dude, thanks for making homecoming so special for us. Thanks for always giving back and celebrating CSU. We appreciate it very much.
Well, I appreciate you guys. And thanks again for the great article. It does mean a lot to me. I'm really proud of, proud of my history there at CSU. Proud to be a Rammy. Go Rammies.
Go Rams.
Anytime you guys need anything, let me know, man. I appreciate you all very much. And hopefully somebody goes down to Lucky Joe's and drinks a 90 shilling for me tonight.
We just got the go ahead that bars can open till midnight. So I'm sure they're getting it going right now.
There you go. Love it, well, man.
We had the barbecue live streamed in, and President McConnell and Coach Hilbert joined us. So we're so thankful for everybody that joined on that side, and our special guest, as well as everybody who joined us on Instagram. Don't forget to head over to CSU Alumni Association Facebook. They're lighting the A, and they're going to show it on our Facebook. So, John, if you want to head over there too, you can see the A lit up.
I'm going to do it, brother.
All right. I'm going to order me some John.
Have a good night, everybody. Go Rams.
Thanks.
Good night, Rams.
Bye. Thanks, everyone. Go Rams.
Go Rams.
Go Rams.
Go Rams.
Holly, so nice to see you again.
Good to see you too. Yes.
Next time we're in Dallas, we'll get together again, huh?
That would be wonderful. Yes. Awesome. Oh, my microphone's here. Yeah, that'd be great. Yeah. Well, same thing. Hopefully we'll make it up there soon. Hopefully. It's not a bad drive from Texas, but